Yo, what's up? I'm Martha from Galena Cube, and not that long ago I did a video on data agents inside of Fabric, and I asked you guys what else can we do apart from having business use it to chat and ask questions and get better insights. And then Chris Webb answered my prayers because he posted a blog post stating that what if we use the Fabric data agent to document our semantic models? Genius. We don't want to spend time on documentation, that's boring, and this might be the perfect use case for Fabric data agents to help us. So what I want to do now is replicate what Chris wrote in his blog post and also see if I'm able to like scale it a bit. So you know what I like to do? Enough of all this talking, let's head over to my laptop. So I'm following the steps in Chris's blog, and essentially what he does is he is pulling in the semantic model that he wants to document, and then he uses the info calc dependency DAX function. This DAX function is pretty nice because what it does is that it provides us with a list of all the different columns and tables and measures that you have in your semantic model, and also the relationships between them, and also the expression for each of these. So there's a bunch of information obviously in this table, but I don't want to spend time understanding this, but this is actually a nice starting point to see if a data agent can use this information and turn it into documentation. So what we then do is that we go into Fabric. So what I've done here is that I just created a new data agent, and you do this very easily by just clicking new item, finding data agent here, and then create a new one. And then I added a data source. So that is the semantic model that we just looked at in Power BI. So I published this model, and then I want to pull in specifically this table here. That's the table we just looked at, which was the result of the infocalc dependency DAX function. And then I need to also give it some instructions. And these instructions here are copy paste from Chris Webb's blog. Thank you, Chris. And I'm telling the data agent how to interpret the table. Then I just simply in the chat ask it, please generate some documentation for the measures listed in YouTube metrics, metrics analytics calc dependency table. That was the beautiful name I chose for my table. And then describe what each calculation does and how it works. And then you see here that it's providing us a pretty nice description of the different measures, even showing us the DAX setup. So obviously, great success. This was a bit of a manual approach. Obviously, I pulled it into Power BI. I executed the DAX expression, then I published it, and then I asked the data a question, and then it created this information. Now, what if we want to scale this? Well, the beauty of data agents is that they are programmatic. So let's take a look at how we could do that. Okay, so I created a new workspace for us, and I set up a notebook. So the first step is to then run the infocalc dependency DAX function in a way that is programmatic and also scalable. So we could, of course, take advantage of SIMPy. So that's what I'm doing in a notebook, importing that. And then what you can take advantage of then is the evaluate DAX function that you have here. And then actually directly run the DAX query, evaluate infocalc dependency for the specified workspace ID and dataset ID that you want to run this on. And obviously, I hope you see this here. You could, of course, parametricize this, and you could pull in, anything. So what you're seeing here is giving me a list of all the different objects and items and the relationship between them. Cool, so I have the data. And what I'm doing then is I'm just saving that data into a pandas data frame and then saving it as a table in my documentation lakehouse. Also, I had to specify to remove the brackets for the data agent not to get confused. That's just a little tip. And now that table with all that information is, of course, ready to use for a data agent. So then the next step was to programmatically find a way to have the data agent evaluate that data. And then, of course, I'm going to use notebooks again. So here I installed the Fabric Data Agent SDK. Then I imported what I needed from the data agent client. I also installed a pretty print messages because that's going to make our life a little easier when we're running the scripts. And then I defined the actual data agent name. So you can create a new data agent or use an existing one. And now you can programmatically provide the AI instruction. So these ones are the same that I gave here. I can also then add the lakehouse that I wanted to use as a source. So instead of using a semantic model, I'm going to use the documentation lakehouse as the source. And then I also need to select the specific tables that I wanted to use. So I want the metrics analytics calc dependency table to be the one that it uses. Then I can also print the sources and just see that it selected all of these inside of this table. And then we're ready to publish the data agent. Now what you can do is decide to call that data agent specifically and then ask the question of, please generate some documentation for measures. This is the same question that I asked directly in the chat. And here you see that it's actually able to provide us with all that information on the different measures. Awesome. And then what I did was to save that data specifically as a file under model documentation. I actually saved that both a CSV file and a markdown file because I wanted to test. So now the cool part is that if I go into, for instance, I go into GitHub and then I have this model documentation demo markdown file here. If I open up that, you see, this is actually the text that the agent gave me. So it's already on markdown format. And then if I go to preview, you see, wow, it's already beautiful and ready. It looks like actual documentation, just like that. And I didn't have to write a word. Amazing. The boring days of documenting our semantic models, I feel like they're done. Now the next step would be to pull this maybe into a pipeline, have a list of all the different workspaces you want to run this with. Maybe you want to have this as a setup that you run for each of your production workspaces where you have semantic models. I don't know, there's so many ways to do this. Any other use cases I should test, challenge me in the comments below. Check out all the other videos from Adam, Patrick and myself, of course, and we will see you guys in the next one. Bye.